Good afternoon, everyone. This is Mike Romali here with the Hurricane Outlook and Discussion for August 23rd, 2021, around 2:15 p.m. Eastern Time. We have a lot to talk about today, including the potential for three tropical storms to be forming over the next couple days, so let's kind of jump straight into everything. Taking a wild look across the tropical Atlantic this afternoon, we continue to monitor an area of disturbed weather right now near the Lesser Antilles. This will be moving westward during the next several days, and development chances will increase as this interacts with a monsoon trough, and areas here in the Caribbean could be dealing with a tropical cyclone, potentially for some of the same areas that were impacted heavily by Grace the other day. We are also monitoring this tropical wave here with a medium 40% chance as this moves generally towards the west-northwest here, and we are also watching another tropical wave here, which will kind of be doing something like this. And this also, all of these systems each have a 40% chance of development. We can see here on the graphical tropical weather outlook, again, this is invest area 97L right here. This is 97L. This will soon be 98L and what could become 99L. All of these systems will be moving generally towards land. This one here will be impacting or could get close to Bermuda. This one will be turning away, but we'll have to watch to see if a ridge of high pressure sets up to the north. And of course, this one here in the Caribbean, this will be impacting land during the next several days or so as this moves generally towards the west-northwest here. So again, looking here at Invest Area 97L, not really much is ongoing with it. We notice that, again, there is a little bit of vorticity with it in the middle part of the atmosphere right here and just some shallow convection, not a really a lot here. That's because we have a lot of dry, stable air. If we kind of look here at the water vapor satellite imagery, we notice that, again, there's a fair bit here of dry, stable air around the storm. And development chances really will not begin to increase until this reaches closer to Bermuda, which is just right here. So as this tracks near Bermuda, this will have a gradual risk for development. This is the extent here of the Cabo Verde Islands right there. And this other tropical wave back here, again, could develop into something as it turns generally away and out to sea there. And again, we're looking at a wide loop here. Again, this is the tropical wave that we'll be watching over the next several days for any development down there. Not really a super big concern. Again, this should turn on out to sea. But my biggest concern probably is going to be this tropical wave here as it interacts with the developing Central American Gyre. Now, upper ocean heat content wise, again, this is the upper ocean heat content map updated as of this morning. Again, for context here, these reds and whites, the lighter blue colors onwards towards the right of the scale, the oranges and red colors here, this indicates fairly high upper ocean heat content. Again, we notice that, again, the upper ocean heat content is not substantially high where 97L is right now. It will be moving into an area of gradually increasing sea surface temperatures and upper ocean heat content as the days go by. What could be 98 or 99L depends on which system gets tagged first. This right now is located in a fairly potent area of upper ocean heat content. We're moving out here, and by the time it turns, it will still be in an area of very favorable sea surface temperatures in this region. The only thing that might prohibit it is Saharan air to the north and just dry air. But for the most part, this will be located in a fairly prime environment for most of its lifetime. Again, really the only major problem here is the fact that it would be turning northward. And again, just depends what happens with the ridge to the north. Now, as for our tropical wave that is now past the Lesser Antilles that will be impacting or that could be impacting portions of the Yucatan Peninsula over the next 5 days, again, the upper ocean heat content in this part of the world is fairly high. Again, a lot of it was not upwelled from Grace. Again, Grace was a pretty fast mover through this area and really only slowed down through here. But even so, the upper ocean heat content really hasn't been affected all that much, and it's still fairly high through this area. Now, we can dive into the modeling here and take a look at all the dynamical responses that's going to be impacting all of these systems during the next several days. So first of all, we'll start off at the 850 millibar vorticity. So this is the spin in the atmosphere at about 5,000 feet off the ground. And these darker red colors here indicate higher cyclonic spin at 5,000 feet. We notice that, again, we have a ridge that's kind of positioned something like this. It's pretty broken right now because we have this big trough over the middle part of the Atlantic basin extending all the way down to the Azores Islands here. But with this being said, there is a weakness in this ridge, and that's why our systems are allowed to gain latitude at this time. So all of our systems eventually gain some latitude because the weakness in the ridge, and we can kind of go up to the 500 millibar vorticity to kind of explain this. Again, we can kind of see that we have kind of a part of the ridge here. We also have a part of the ridge here, but they're not really conjoined through here. There is a weakness in this ridge between the 591 decameter heights and the 588 decameter heights. So there's a weakness here in part because of this big trough to the north. And this trough to the north, again, is mainly going to be steering our storms generally towards the north. Now, again, they will follow some of the low-level flow, which means they won't turn dramatically north like this. So there is a growing risk that, again, 97L, which is this storm here, could in fact get closer to Bermuda over the next several days and try to develop from there on forward. Now, again, the GFS, if we go back to the low-level flow, we notice that, again, right now our storm, both of our systems or all three of our systems really aren't doing too much through Thursday. But eventually the GFS, we kind of take notice here, tries to develop this system here. And then here is what would likely be 98 or 99L, just depending on what gets named first or designated first. This could be future Ida right here as it heads towards the Yucatan Peninsula. Now, we'll zoom in here at a western Atlantic look and take a look here at the 200 millibar wind. Again, this would be a very favorable outflow pattern for something to develop. The one problem is with these monsoon troughs, again, you can kind of just follow in the low levels, you have wind coming like this and curling around. This is a broad Central American gyre, and it's very rare to have something like this in late, late August. This would be out to about August 28th. So this is late August. We're seeing these Central American gyres. Typically, this is a late September, October, November type pattern than it is a late August, early September pattern. Needless to say, though, this upper level flow is very conducive for tropical cyclones to develop and maintain themselves within. The only problem is these Central American gyres, they tend to be very broad, disorganized, and it takes a while for something to actually consolidate. If you look here at the moisture field in the mid-levels of the atmosphere, again, we can see this broad fetch here of tropical moisture, something trying to consolidate here on the center part of this. Now, if something were to consolidate further north here, it may have a better chance of missing land and making its way in towards the kind of central, you know, south-central Gulf of Mexico there. On the GFS forecast, though, this moves into the Yucatan Peninsula. Again, similar to what Grace did, although Grace was a little bit further north. Now, again, these details will have to be refined. Again, this is just beyond the five-day realm here at hour 126, so the typical stopping point of the H-Wharf runs. Now, again, because we have not seen these systems be designated, we're not going to see runs here on the H-Wharf or H-Mon, etc. But the global models are fairly definitely robust with this. They're excited, or I guess enthused is a better terminology, for tropical cyclone genesis in this region. And again, the 200 millibar wind flow in the upper part of the atmosphere, very conducive for something to develop. And again, even down here, again, similar to where Grace was the other day, we have a system here just beyond 5 days by Monday, August 30th, that could be approaching in towards the Yucatan Peninsula. Now, again, this is a little far out in time, but if we were to take a look here at what's going on, we'll take a look here at the 500 millibar height anomalies, actually, at the 500 millibar heights. We notice that right now, again, this would be valid for Monday. We have a building ridge of high pressure to the north. So again, that generally is going to keep these storms suppressed into kind of Mexico here. Now, if something were to develop a little bit further northward, again, we could see a system that tries to take more of a track further northward in towards the northern part of the Yucatan Peninsula, but it would likely bend back towards the west. Again, you know, these model forecasts will change, and, you know, the ridge may not be as strong, or the ridge may not even be here on the forecast run, you know, 4 or 5 days from now. So it's very important to kind of monitor the trends of this, but the trends have been towards a system that ends up developing down here in the Caribbean and takes a track similar, but spends a little bit more time over the Yucatan, but very similar to something like Grace. But again, not necessarily the intensity. Again, the upper level outflow pattern is there. But the problem is these monsoon troughs take so long to consolidate that it's going to be hard to get something to develop out there and really strengthen. Now, in the GFS runs here also, we noticed that, again, we'll be watching for, again, we could have a storm interact with baroclinic processes up here as it heads towards the Azores Islands, and this might be something to watch for them. But again, generally speaking, then at this part, we'll have this developing trough up here to the north. And again, creates a natural weakness in the ridge here. And again, this ridge will begin to break down over the next several days. Eventually, though, with time, this ridge will begin to set in. And you notice that the GFS here is trying to develop something out in the far long range out here with this ridge that sets up down here. And that is certainly possible. If we kind of look here at the GFS ensembles, and if we look here at the 500 millibar vorticity, what we'll notice is, again, we have this ridge that kind of develops to the north. And if we were to take a look at that even more on the 500 millibar heights, again, we notice this ridge that kind of sets up right here in the long range. And this could be generally a very nasty steering flow that generally tracks storms generally more towards the west. European ensembles, just real quickly, again, the European is fairly interesting. Again, we noticed that in the short term, our system down here, 97L, doesn't really have much chance of developing. Now, notice here, watch our storm out here. This is our developing system out here in the Caribbean as it generally tries to track in towards the Bay of Campeche, southern Gulf of Mexico. This eventually crosses here, and then there's a large track divergence here of several hundred miles. Again, anywhere from a very weak storm down here confined to Mexico and kind of the, you know, Bay of Campeche region to a storm that is stronger and further northward. So there's a wide range of track possibilities here. You notice another system, this would be featured 97L that tries to develop out in this region after some time. And again, a look here at the very long range forecast, more ensemble members developing a storm out there. So there's a lot to watch. Again, it's not really a guarantee that we'll see any land threats for the next several weeks. Again, it's still that kind of early season pattern. Again, the peak of the hurricane season isn't until September 10th. And I do suspect that, again, the first couple of weeks of September will be absolutely crazy. And probably into October as well, that it will be pretty busy. So with that being said, again, have your hurricane preparedness plans ready. We've already seen 3 hurricanes this season, and we're likely to see more upcoming. All right. With that being said, I hope you have a great rest of your afternoon and evening. Of course, I am Michael Romali. I'll talk to you guys again some more tomorrow.